बीजी तोरी सी को बायो विरादांत मुना स्तुरगम जय अजतांति यंतुमति लोलोम पायो खिदो व्यसन सतामृतो समवहायो गुरोश्चरणं बनिजय वाज संतकृत कर्णधरा जलधौ। सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद चोल आंटिल एंड अनलेस यू आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन गुरु तत्व यू कैन नॉट स्टार्ट हरि भजन। शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद चोल आंटिल एंड अनलेस यू आर कंप्लीटली एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन गुरु तत्व यू कैन नॉट स्टार्ट हरि भजन। एक्चुअल हरि भजन, एक्चुअल हरि भजन यू कैन स्टार्ट ओनली देन, नॉट बिफोर दैट। गुरु तत्व इज इक्वल टू माई गुरु पाद पद्म, गुरु तत्व इज इक्वल टू सिसिल गोसाई महाराज हु इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम माई गुरुपाद पद्म। गुरु तत्व इज इक्वल टू भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर। आई मीन व्हाट? आई मीन गुरु तत्व इज इक्वल टू सदगुरु। आई वॉन्ट टू स्पीक सो मेनी थिंग बट ड्यू टू डिस्टर्बेंस आई फील अनइजी, आई कैनॉट एक्सप्लेन प्रॉपरली। Many time before I explain, even yesterday I touched this point, that transcendental sound is equal to the object it means. Those who are established in Siddhanta, Tattva, they are Guru Tattva. I mean what they speak, what they exhibit in their own life, that is equal to Guru Tattva. Their life itself is equal to Guru Tattva, because there cannot be any fault. Those bonded soul, they are put into this material planet, they have some defects, they have some faults, they have some defects, they have some defective organs, I mean sense organs, through which what they realize, what they see, what they speak, what they hear, all full of problem. I mean, not absolute truth. Sometime we come to Guru Pad Padma, and sometime we take Diksha, we can exhibit that we are doing Guru Seva. You see, I am a big sevak. I am number one sevak of my Guru Pad Padma. Yesterday I already told this point. Every year after Gaur Purnim Parikram, when those devotees coming to Prabhupada to take permission, Prabhupada, please permit us, we like to go back to our home. Prabhupada couldn't speak even a single word, only weeping, shedding tears. Because what to speak? What to speak? Prabhupada repeatedly requesting them, don't try to deprive me. Don't try to deprive me, don't try to cheat me. Because you all promised me that you will do Hari Bhajan. You told me you are interested to do Hari Bhajan. First of all, you promise in front of me that you will do Hari Bhajan. But I know you want to deprive me. You are not doing Hari Bhajan. That is not good. Again, you all are going to jump into fire, I mean in family life. If you take shelter of Guru Pad Padma, then all problem is finished. If you take shelter unto the lotus feet of one genuine Sadguru, then and there all of your problem is finished. But usually it is seen, our life is full of problem. Oh, I took Diksha from Srila Bhakti Pramod Purige Srin Guru Maharaj. Ah, you know, 25 years back, yearly so. Prabhupada saying, actual Diksha and so-called Diksha is not same. Actual Diksha and so-called Diksha is not same. Actual Diksha means 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma. You cannot find even a single object, single matter, which is related to my personal interest. I am sitting in Vyasasan. If you find anything in my life, this bag, this anything in your life, all I think I took from my Guru Maharaj. In this material world, I have nothing, not even a single object which I can deserve. That bank balance is my bank balance. It is not Guru Maharaj's balance. This building you see is made by me. It's my building. But one genuine devotee, after 100% submission, he cannot speak that way. Not possible. The sloka I started with is very nice, excellent sloka. If you explain this sloka for 1 month, I can go on speaking gradually from different angles. It is from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto. 10th canto. 87th chapter, I think. Yes. There you can find those Vedas, Upanishad Vedas, they are reciting some hymns. They are doing stuti to Krishna. When Krishna in the form of Narayana sleeping in the ocean of Karan Sai for the 4 months, consecutively for the 4 months, we observe this Chaturmasa Vrata. As per Bhagavatam, the Chaturmasa Vrata we can start on Ekadashi, Shayan Ekadashi, and we complete this Vrata on Uttan Ekadashi. Though there is different opinions, but still this is the rules. You can start Chaturmasa Vrata from Purnima to Purnim, from Purnim to Purnim. That is also welcome. You can start your Vrata from Dadasi to Dadasi. It's okay. But as per Bhagavatam, Swayan Ekadasi, Krishna sleeping in our life, our sleeping is the property of Tamaguna. But Krishna, I mean Narayana, not sleeping that way. Shuddha Shata, Narayana, Krishna. There cannot be any sleep. Sleeping is a matter which is related to our daily life. We sleep. We can go to sleep, we can get up. But Krishna is always alert, 100% consciousness, always, every time. All over this universe, infinity universe, anywhere, anything happening, instant Krishna can know. Guru Tattva, Krishna Tattva is very typical. You can memorize many sloka. You can give speech in front of lakhs of people. What it concerns to me? You can recite, your memory is very good, you can recite many sloka. But without realization, your knowledge is not perfect. And realization only can be given by Guru Pad Padma and Vaishnavas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, who is Vaishnava? That is Guru. Who is Guru? He is Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava? Is Guru. Same Tattva. Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, not different. Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, not different. One day it happened so, some so-called devotee running to Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, paying dandavat, and speaking, Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj asking, where from you are coming? Oh, I am coming from Navadvipa. There are nice Rasa Leela Kirtan going on. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, don't go there. Why? So nice Rasa Kirtan going there. If we go, we can enjoy. Everybody crying. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, they have some passive sex in their life. Don't go there. They are not actually shedding tears. Tears is different kind of tears. Tears, as per science, if you tears out of enjoyment, I mean out of ecstasy, transcendental love, that tears is different. When somebody insults you, giving you pain, beat you, that time some sort of tear coming out, that is also different. When some near and dear ones, your beloved person going on from this material world, suppose your son, suppose your father, mother, then you are shedding tears, that is also different qualities. Scientifically different property. Scientifically different property. If you analyze the water, you can find. Follow. So Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, they are shedding tears out of their karma. They have dirty karma inside their heart. Don't go there. Actually, there, if you like to hear Harikatha, first of all, you have to wait and see what kind of reaction you feel in front of that speaker. So many secret things are there in bhajan. See, even if you go to jungle, I am very sorry to speak this point. Even if you go to jungle, forest, there even you can find some sort of rules are there among any animals. Those who are animals, they follow some rules and regulation. I give one example. Suppose one deer, or rhino, anybody, elephant, taking water, I mean going to a pond, to drink water. In Bhagavatam also you can find Jarabharat incident, you can find that harin, that deer, taking water. Sea deer. Sea is taking, drinking water. In the meantime, she could hear a big sound of a tiger. Whom? She thought tiger already come and catching me. But not that. The tiger was long away from that spot. But what I mean to say, one deer, if suppose the deer taking water from one place, drinking water, that time even tiger, lion, nobody can attract that creature. Never. So nice regulation said by Supreme Lord into their heart. But I am so brute, I am not ready to follow even a single rules and regulation of this Vaishnava society. So painful situation persisting in this present spiritual world. Nobody can understand the secrecy of bhajan. That is a big problem. Today, I like to discuss this point. If you are failure to understand the spiritual feature of your Guru Pad Padma, I mean Bani Sharup, if you fail to understand, if you fail to see the transcendental feature, I mean Bani Sharup of your Guru Pad Padma, then you are 100% failure in this bhajan life. You are 100% failure in this bhajan life. Because you cannot see the transcendental feature, I mean Bani Sarupa or Guru Pad Padma. Guru Pad Padma, his body is not made up of flesh and blood and like me. First point you will have to realize. Then you can start your actual Hari Bhajan. If we go through the life history of all our Guru Varga, if I like to speak about myself, but who care to hear about me? But one point Prabhupada told, unless you can sell your head unto the lotus feet of your Guru Pad Padma, unless you can sell, you will have to sell your head. If you like to cross this material world, this life, if you want to cross this material world, this life, then you will have to sell your head. If somebody can speak to me, Maharaj, if you cut your head and throw in front of Guru Pad Padma, you can get Krishna this life. Then I am ready. Very cheap. I can get Krishna so cheap, Krishna? I can get Krishna so easily? What value is there with my head? If somebody promise, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu promise, to whom? Whom? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu promised to whom? Mukunda. Mukunda was almost Sahajya. Mukunda was almost, not actually Sahajya. He played the role as if he is Sahajya. Because no Sahajya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot accept any Sahajya. But he is person as associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So it is wrong Siddhanta. So it seems he is Sahaja. As per the version of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I cannot give kippa to him. He is Sahaja. Anywhere in any society he is going, he is just get adjusted in this situation. So how I can say no exclusiveness is there with him? He can mix with all people. But pure devotees, they cannot have that kind of tendency. They always feel some sort of exclusiveness. Because many times I told you, you can remember, Prabhupada told, we Gauriya, we must maintain some sort of speciality with us. We Gauriya, we have some speciality with us. Speciality? You are so proud? You speak this way? No! No! What I wanted to speak? Prabhupada used to speak. We Gauriyas, we have some speciality with us. What do you mean by that speciality? Prabhupada speaking. Speciality regarding Siddhanta. speciality regarding seva. Many times I discussed this point, you can remember. Because what I am speaking in Siddhanta, that can be translated into seva. Seva and Siddhanta almost same thing. Vice versa. Like energy theory, you can remember. As per Einstein theory, matter can be converted into energy. 0.001 milligram uranium can be converted into energy. 0.001, I used to read Nelcon and Packer from England, physics book. They are sure. Nelcon and Packer, physics books from England, when I was a school final student. There. Big, very nice, advanced physics. 0.001 milligram uranium can be converted into energy. But you cannot conceive, you cannot calculate what an enormous amount of energy can produce. According to this theory, we get thermal power. Thermal power. Thermal means now actually atomic power. We get enormous energy, electrical power, according to this theory. At present, those scientists, they are calculating that matter can be converted into energy. At the same time, energy can be converted into matter. I can explain this point, maybe not in English, maybe Bengali, somewhere, if I get V volumes of thesis I can discuss. Not hypothesis, thesis. Hypothesis is always not genuine. Thesis is genuine. So you see, what I wanted to speak before that? We must maintain speciality regarding Siddhanta and Seva. What is called Siddhanta, that is Seva, that can be converted into Seva. And Seva, I can speak literally language, because I told language and the object is same, in transcendental world. Be careful. So the feature of Srila Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj is equal to a bani he reserved for us. Whole life we can discuss those banis and his activities very life, in his life. He was a beloved person of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Personal associates of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Sometimes somebody fight in different sabha. Maharaj, all the devotees, those who took shelter unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, they are all personal associates of Prabhupada. I say, no, wrong. It cannot be so. All different people, they took shelter unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, they are not all personal associates of Prabhupada. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personal associate, who can be called as associates? Because personal associates, his actual activity, what is actually, like, how you can identify? If you find he is going to implement the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu into action, he is personal associates. Follow. So many people can enjoy the kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time it was a special chance for bonded soul to get kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That was a special case. Like in market you saw, when you go, 50% off sale going on. 50% off. That time was a special case. Patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param vikshate दया देव विमर्शक नहि नव काल प्रतीक्षा प्रभु whom to give, whom not to give, that kind of judgment was not there at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Any people come in front of Nityananda Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, go, take kipa. Maharaj, there is no pot to keep, take kipa. Maharaj, there is no pot to take kipa. Suppose I like to give you some milk prasadam. You say, Maharaj, I have no pot with me. Say, so, yeah, you get pot? Otherwise, how can give? How I can give? But at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that question was very flat question, very flat rate. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, oh, you don't have pot to take kipa? Okay, I can give pot. I can give pot, I can give rasa, both, kipa. Without pot, how you can keep? Many people hearing Harikatha, but they cannot keep Tata Siddhanta into because they are chanchal, so fickle minded. So, Param Pujyavad Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, he wrote in Prabhupada Stava, Prabhupada Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Potitodharane kritovesha jatim. Those who are fallen soul, to deliver them, he took sannyas. Same mood like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, they are not ready to pay dandavat to me. They like to insult me, they like to beat me. They resolve into their heart, who is Nimai? He is showing some excesses. We like to beat him. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu say, I come in this material planet to deliver them, but they like to beat me? Eh? They cannot realize my heart? So I can do one thing. Instant I can take sannyas and I go room to room, home to home, and pay unto their lotus feet. Please sing Krishna. What is my begging objective? I like to beg, Bolo Krishna, Kaho Krishna, Karo Krishna, Sikhya. No rice, chapati, dal, nothing. Prasadam Krishna can arrange by any way. So you see, same mood like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas with the mood that at least they can see my sannyas wish, at least they can express some sympathy for me. Oh, that Nimai was so intelligent, so big pandit. Now he lived a family life, he goes sannyas. At least they can have some softness into their heart for me. At least they can say, okay, dandavat. Because sannyas, if you take sannyas, even your father or mother, they will have to pay dandavat to you. If you take sannyas, if somebody is taking sannyas, it is the rules. His father must pay dandavat to his son. Otherwise, he will have to go for expiation. Expiation. Without expiation, that cannot be neutralized. A big fault. So same way, Prabhupada told everybody like to beat me, finish me. Okay. I can take sannyas under the guidance of Srila Ramanujacharya. He took sannyas from his Guru Padma. Ramanujacharya took sannyas from his Guru Padma photo. But somebody can fight Maharaj. They took sannyas from photo. What wrong if I take sannyas from photo? You are brute. You cannot calculate the exact thesis, Siddhanta. In Bhagavatam you can find eight types of vigra there. Eight types of. Out of sand, iron, metal, mentally, earth, different kind of. stone, jewel, different kind. Out of that one, photo is also approved. Vigraha, 8 types of vigraha there. 8 different types. Out of that, one is photo. But provided that, if you see the picture of Srila Gauranga Mahaprabhu's Gaur Nityananda, if you can 100% realize that this is Gaur Nityananda, no other than Gaur Nityananda. I told one incident, you see in Kalna, on Gaurdas Pandit, Gaur Nityananda used to go there. Someday they like to go away. No, I cannot allow you two to go from here. Oh, allow me. We have some seva. You will have to allow us to go. No, I cannot allow. Gauridas, you do one thing. You can make 2 deities. Gaur Nityananda. Okay, I can make. Gauridas make 2 deities. Gaur Nityananda. And establish into temple as it is. And someday Gaur Nityananda speaking, now we are going. No. What happens? The 2 deities there is equal, same as we are. No, I cannot allow you to go. Okay, we are going to stay with you. But the 2 deities started moving. He is running and catching. Why are you going? Then these 2 Gaur Nityananda become deity. Then Gaur Nityananda prove that deity means my deity is equal to me myself. There should not be any doubt in it. Follow this example, scientific example. If you, that day I was speaking, maybe somewhere I was speaking Bengali Harikatha Mayapur, before coming here. If I ask you, have you seen Supreme Lord? Yes, sir. Yeah, actually, you see Krishna? No, actually, I couldn't see Krishna as yet. Foolish. You don't see Krishna? Vigraha nau tumi sakshat brajananandan. You don't have 100% belief in it? You can say this much, well, Maharaj, I already see Vigraha, I already see Krishna, but I couldn't realize properly. That much you can say. But you cannot say this lie, that I never see Krishna. Yes, I see Krishna. I see Gaur Nityananda. You don't see Gaur Nityananda? Standing here, you see. That Gaur Nityananda can speak with you. I have seen Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, Devananda Guru Acharya, I was stunned. Many years back, 15, 16 years back, I cannot remember now. That time I used to stay in Vrindavan, but actually Vrindavan, I couldn't see Vrindavan. Materially, I was staying in Vrindavan. I used to come sometime here in Calcutta after train journey. First, I used to go to Devananda Guru Mat, change my clothes, take bath. After that, I had the scope to see living Vigraha of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, Sai Pai Dandabat. I have seen Bhaman Goswami Maharaj one day. I see Bhaman Goswami Maharaj from his bhajan kuri going just one step up, one staircase, and going to Vigraha, temple, just downstairs there up. And paying dandavat to Radha Vinod Bihari, Gaurhari. I was stunned. I was sitting backside. I saw Bhaman Goswami Maharaj talking with Vigraha. He's talking. I have seen my Guru Maharaj talking with Vigraha. At old age, 98, 95. They, Janardhan Maharaj, senior, he is very old man in bhajan line. Guru Maharaj, I have seen everybody, you know. Guru Maharaj paying dandavat to Vigraha, Radha Gopinath. With Vigraha old age, you see, he is paying full dandavat, prostrated. After that, trembling, shaking. and shedding tears, as if talking with Radha Gopinath. Perhaps you have seen one picture that Guru Maharaj paying prostrate dandavandana to the lotus feet of Radha Kunda Radharani. One picture published from Chaitanya Gauriamath. Guru Maharaj paying dandavandana to Radha Kunda. Everybody said, full in road, paying dandavandana, saying tears. Follow? Why I come to this point? Because to give some alertness in you. This photo is equal to the deity. So, when Ramanujacharya took sannyas from photo, it was actually his Gurudev. Because full feature, spiritual feature of Guru Padmasambhava was totally unveiled, expressed into his heart. Said no wrong in it. When Prabhupada took sannyas from photo of Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, everybody fired him. He took sannyas from photo, what's that? He break rules? No. He took sannyas from Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj himself. No photo. You see photo. This is a Siddhanta. So, now I come back to this point. Srila Goswami Maharaj, his name was given Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj. Saranga. You know the meaning of Saranga? You don't know? Saranga means, as per Sanskrit language it is, Saranga means honeybees, as per Bhagavatam. You can find in Bhagavatam first canto, regarding Parikshit Maharaj's discussion there, after taking bath. There the rishis, they are forecasting. He is Saranga Iva Sarabhuk. He can take the vitals, honey from flower, without disturbing the flower. The speciality of honeybees, what's that? If you try to get some honey out of flower, it's dangerous. You can bring all flowers in your kitchen and put it into grinder, and but you cannot give in. You cannot get even a drop of honey out of that. There is a natural rule set by supreme law. If you need honey, you will have to go to honeybees. You will have to depend upon honeybees. Without that, any scientific research cannot come out successful in this matter. Similarly, you cannot come out successful without the fullest kripa of Guru Padma, who is a honeybees. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lotus feet, it is like lotus flower. And all honeybees, those who are the personal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they experience some humming news. Boom. Because so long as you are hovering around this flower, lotus, up to that point some humming sound can come. But as and when that honeybee sit into this flower and start sucking honey, then there is no sound. Sound? They sound? No sound. Because they already started sucking honey. There's no disturbance, no fighting. Only now they are sucking honey. Same thing. So, Gosai Maharaj, his name was given honeybees. Saranga Iva Sarabhuk, Parikshit Maharaj, Saranga Iva Sarabhuk. So Goswami Maharaj was giving this name, very excellent name. What is called Saranagati? What is called inclination? What is called submission? I cannot explain 100%. Because any amount of philosophy is not equal to the object I mean, because I am a material person. Understand? So it's good if I give some example of Goswami Maharaj, very, very excellent example. Very, very excellent example. Like, Maharaj was a big learned man. At the time of British period, he was highly honored by British officers. He was one railway officials there in Dhanbad. Dhanbad, one place near Durgapur. After Durgapur, Dhanbad, you can, if you go to Vrindavan, you can have the chance to cross this this Dhanbad station. Many times you go by train, you can meet Durgapur, Asansol, Dhanbad. The Dhanbad, there he was a big railway officer, administrator. He was highly honored by British officers because his English was so high quality, the nobody can understand how high quality. That time, one by chance, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami went to some place, so by chance he was bound to stay in Dhanbad station for some period. It was a matter of chance. He will have to change train, stand for 1 hour or 2 hours, after that next train coming. But by that time, luckily, I mean it was set by Supreme Lord, because he is personal associates of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. He came and paid dandavat to Prabhupada, railway station. He doing bandana. Can you please come to my room to purify me and my whole life? Prabhupada saw his personal associates. He is expressing this kind of leela. Well, I can go, but not for long time, but short time. Okay, it's near. My quarter is just near. Went. They was given big honor, spiritual honor. And Prabhupada was there for some time. She speaks some harikatha, very short harikatha. And Goswami Maharaj feel reaction, heavy reaction into her. As if nobody is there in this material planet whom I can speak, he is my. She amar. Whom you can say? Only Guru Padma you can say. It's mine. He could realize, big reaction, oh, it seems he is my personal property, a Prabhupada. Then after that, then and there, submission was done actually then. Many times I explained this point by Rupa Goswami Pad. Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. From Rasamrita Sindhu, you can find one sloka by Rupa Goswami Pad. He quote from some shastra. Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. But we cannot understand this point. Adau Guru Padasraya means, first of all, you will have to submit unto the lotus feet of that supreme person, Gurupad Padma. First, like I give example from Ramayana, Mahabharata, many Purana I can see. When Sita Devi was supposed to choose his groom, whom she can get as a life partner. That time it was the rule, the open Shava, open many important personalities, they can come in front of you. You have the chance to choose whom you like to get as your partner of life. Sita Devi, Draupadi, all same. Swayambhar is called. After that, after Swayambhar, you can marry. A marriage ceremony can be done after. First of all, you have to give garland. Choose first. Same thing with Guru Padma. When you see one super personality, Guru Padma, then your heart becomes sick. Whom I see? He is not ordinary personality. Guru Tattva, I started with Guru Tattva. So I come back to this point. When I saw my Guru Padma, I am sitting in Vyasasana, 100% somebody told from my heart, this is your Guru Padma. When I saw only one picture of Guru Padma in Vrindavan, I was like mad, running here and there with devotees. And suddenly I stepped into one shop, book stall, and I was mad, you see, crazy. At random, I took this magazine, how much this is, how much this book, I was asking like madman. And I took one magazine, oh, I give one picture, oh, I get my Guru Padma. I see the picture of one old man, I never meet before, but 100% from heart, somebody is speaking, this is your Guru Padma. You are searching for so long, you already get. I see the address. After they say, oh, go. Then I come back. From there, I take rest that side of river. And morning time, I already see some supernatural thing in dream. And I cross the river, I meet my Guru Padma, same day. Practical example. I am not speaking even a 1% lie. Same thing. If you try to get Sadguru, same thing happen. It is supposed to happen in your life. Without that, not possible. When Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami went to Russia, Kamalaksha, you know, Kamalaksha, Russian devotee? Kamalaksha staying there? Kamalaksha's mother came to meet Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami. He never before in his life, she never meet one sadhu. She coming to see Tirtha Goswami. Even she don't know how to pay dandavat. But she look at Tirtha Goswami Maharaj and started crying. Unabated crying. Non-stop crying. Nobody can understand why she is crying. Tirtha Maharaj is not speaking even a single word, nothing. Only she looking and shedding tears continuously. So what is the mystery inside this incident? Can you speak? Can you explain? What is the secrecy lying in it? Because she could realize something which is extraordinary. She could realize something, spiritual thing. She could realize some spiritual thing which is extraordinary. By the darshan of Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, she could realize that life is very short. From inside somebody say, what you are doing? Why you are wasting your time? Life is very short. Any time you can go away. She, this Mahapurusha. Understand? So some sort of reaction must be there. In scripture it is written, Sadhu Darshan is inevitable. His reaction is 100%. Sanatan Goswami, Rupa Goswami writing, Sadhu Darshan, it is inevitable, that reaction. Like poison, without knowing if you take poison, poison cannot excuse you. Excuse you? No. Poison can say, oh, he says, Even in fire, one child giving hand, fire is not going to compromise with that child. Though compromise was done about Prahlad Maharaj. But no compromise can be done. Fire is going to burn you. Srila Maharaj could feel some reaction because his personal associates. After that, many times it happens so. He is crying for Guru Padma because already he threw his heart, mind unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Though externally you don't find that Srila Goswami Maharaj not yet taken any diksha. Somebody fighting Parikshit Maharaj, who is this Guru Padma? Whom, from whom he took diksha? Foolish. Prabhupada saying they are all foolish. What do you mean by diksha? What do you mean by diksha? Diksha means to get the sense of relationship with Supreme Lord. The procedure through which you can get the knowledge of relationship with Supreme Lord, that is called diksha. Is it done in your life? If done, then you are taking actual diksha. So Prabhupada explained Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. By hearing Bhagavatam from Sukadeva Goswami, he developed the sense of relationship with Supreme Lord. So this is called diksha. And those who are taking mantra, fighting with Guru Padma, they are not getting any kippa, nothing. They like to exploit their Guru Padma. We are so brute. We like to use Guru Padma for our own personal benefit. Prabhupada speaking one nice story. Salagrama, you know Salagrama? Prabhupada telling somebody, some devotee, he is worshipping Salagrama. Sometime he need to break some nut, so he is using that stone. The Salagrama he is worshipping. At the same time he is taking there's no stone. He is taking Salagrama and breaking nut because he likes to take nut. Prabhupada speaking this way. We like to use Guru Vaishnava for our personal benefit. Actually, I am not sevak. If you have any smell of personal interest, then you are not sevak. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in Bhagavatam, Savoy Boniko, he is a businessman. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, who is expecting something from you, he is 100% not sevak. He is actually businessman. He likes to get a transaction. Business transaction, you like to give something from Guru, take something. This is the rules. So now you see, Srila Maharaj took diksha. After diksha, he was actually playing grihastha life. After that, Maharaj, what happens? He lived also, previously when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was, construction was going on, coal field, in Dandrat coal field, he used to go to coal field, beg lot of coal to make bricks, you see, because there was no money. Now any ordinary person can go to foreign country, speak some dry philosophy and get billions of dollars. But that time it was not so easy. Not so easy. Goswami Maharaj used to send 1 rupees or 2 rupees, I think, monthly. 1 rupees or 2 rupees. That 2 rupees was very valuable. Big. Big valuable. After that, Goswami Maharaj, what happens? One day, take one lorry, big car, lorry, you know? Like caravan. All his luggage, going to Prabhupada and submit unto the lotus feet. Prabhupada, I come with my wife, everything, all my, you see, furniture, everything, I throw myself onto your Lord. What to do, what not to do, that is up to you. Then Prabhupada arranged staying in Jagapit for some days. After that, he, Aprakita Brahmachari, He started begging, I mean, bhiksha. Srila Prakita Brahmachari and Hayagriva Brahmachari was the name of Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj. The two super personality, these two. They used to beg for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Prabhupada told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is equal to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We'll have to satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 100% through Sankirtan. And to keep Sankirtan going on, need something? That is also fire sacrifice going on, Sankirtan, Yajna. And Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj and Aprakita Brahmachari, I mean Hayagriva Brahmachari, they are all collecting some fuel for that fire sacrifice. Fuel means money, everything to organize seva of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhupada was 100% happy with their seva. 100% happy with their seva. Very, very seva. After that, Prabhupada sent Goswami Maharaj to foreign country. There he started preaching a very gigantic way. Oh, big preacher. You can get in written some lectures of Goswami Maharaj in English. So nice. I am speaking in brief. One day Goswami Maharaj, fine, he has no or not even a single penny with him. But he need to pay. He need to pay. He cannot go outside because some seva is there. Very urgent seva, bani seva. And he was very thinking about Prabhupada. Prabhupada, what to do now? In the meantime, one postman coming, oh, you have some money order in your name. Money order? Yes. Oh my God. But how to make it in cash? You cannot get cash because it is in paper. He ran to the bank manager, speaking, can you give me cash? Because some... But you have to give your identity. But that time, Maharaj was long away from that spot. Long way. But he need money there, you know. He will have to go back and collect identity card because everybody knows. Rani Elizabeth, everybody knows. Now Maharaj was thinking what to do. Suddenly, he went to bank manager requesting me, oh, without identity card, we cannot give. He suddenly saw one newspaper is there in table. He saw his own picture. Eh? Because just previous day, there was big meeting, spiritual sabha. There all newspaper men took picture of this sannyasis from India. They give the report what he spoke yesterday. He told manager, come on man, this is identity inside your table. Indian table. What do you mean? You see this news. I am Bhakti Saranga Goswami. This is... He saw? Hey? Really saw? Okay. He gave the money to him. So intelligent. Goswami Maharaj. One day all British people, some people coming to fight with him. Can you saw Supreme Lord? You are speaking some philosophy. Can you show your Lord? Suddenly Goswami Maharaj. Suddenly Goswami Maharaj speaking from. Suddenly. It is not slip of tongue. He told, yes, I can show you. Tomorrow morning you come. Tomorrow morning. There is no deity, nothing. Tomorrow morning you come, I can show you. Then night time he is crying, Prabhupada, how to save my prestige? Then morning time, in lawn, one small field is there, he is brushing with nim, one piece of nim. And suddenly he is doing, thinking what to do. Suddenly he saw one Vasudev Vigraha is there. He saw, what is that? Oh my God! four hands, Vasudeva Vigraha there under one tree. He ran and embraced that Vigraha and shedding tears. Oh, you are so merciful, Prabhu. You saved my life. They are supposed to fight with me. Now they cannot fight. Then many people coming, he explained that deity Tata, what do you mean deity? As per our Vedic scriptural analysis, that Vigraha is equal to Supreme Lord, he explained this way. And that deity, I have seen the picture when Gosai Maharaj come back from England, he is stepping down from plane. He is stepping down from plane with a Vigraha here. I have seen in Gauriya. Vigraha here. And Gosai Maharaj with big garland. Coming down. See, if I go on speaking about say, Gosai Maharaj, it is like ocean. And I am like small bird. It's like ocean. If I go on speaking about this Siddhanta, all his activities, what to speak? I am like small bird. I cannot cross this ocean. Only I beg unto the lotus feet of Srila Gosai Maharaj to give full kripa, because I am a very small creature. If he can give full kripa on me, then maybe I can cross this material world and reach lotus feet of my Guru Pad Padma and Gosai Maharaj Prabhupada, because all they are there in one place. Madhav Gosai Maharaj Prabhupada, Gosai Maharaj, our Guru Pad Padma, all they are staying in the same place in Goloka and Navadvip. So I can also reach, though I am not qualified, but still by their mercy I can reach. This much I can say, I like to say so many things, but today life is very limited. Janadharma would like to speak in Bengali also. So I like to stop here. Please excuse me. Vancha kalpataru vasya ki basindu vavacha patitanam pavana vashna bhyo namo.